Hi, it's Susanna B. Troy. We have a lot to cover. First of all, where was Mike Bloomberg during this blizzard? Bermuda? I'd asked that on another YouTube, and he might as well have been. If he was a leader, he would have been checking in every hour in the hour. He would have visited every borough the day of and the next day. That's number one. Number two, John Liu has just put on hold what was going to be a renewal. It involves the NYPD, FDNY, EMS. Bloomberg's techno dreams are the taxpayer's nightmare. And that's also from an old YouTube of mine. It's about CityTime, that my original YouTube, but also it was about this. This, it's not involving SAIC. It's a separate deal, separate contract. But the bottom line is it's just mushrooming out of control. And I'm giving you a link. You have to click on the link and read John Liu's press release. So there's that. The next thing I want to talk to you about is Steve Rattner, Mike Bloomberg's best friend. Steve Rattner is also the best friend of the owner of the New York Times and the owner of the New York Daily News. And he also has managed money for them. He's been involved with them. He used to work at the New York Times. My point, press, media, they back these guys and they cover for them. Because giving you a link to Dan Premack's article from the Fortune magazine, and he slams Steve Rattner. You broke the law. He makes it clear every single way. Yet all he gets is a wrist slap, $10 million. For a rich man like Steve Rattner, $10 million is like you getting fined $10, okay? And he didn't have to plead guilty. It was pay to play, pay to not go to jail, pay to not plead guilty. It's obscene. And Mike Bloomberg, as Dan points out at the end of that article, so you have to read it, he says what I've been saying all along, which is Mike stands by this guy. I want to ask you, how does Mike Bloomberg face the children when he goes with Cathie Black, who has no qualifications, and say to kids, hey, I stand by my best friend who broke the law, refuses to take responsibility for it, refuses to plead guilty, and because he's so rich, he gets to pay millions of dollars to not go to jail. So the bottom line is it's obscene, it's disgusting, and you need to know about it. I'm glad you were angry about the snowstorm, very angry, but you need to be as angry about many other issues, which I continue to talk about on my YouTube channel. Thank you.